evening, you guys. Gonna work on a watercolor. I'm not sure I'm gonna use watercolor. A cat in just a little bit, but I thought I'd show you what Mildred and I found at the Denton Scrap. So I am talking, this is a recording from a live stream, and I am talking to people in the chat. Hi, Button. Hi, Army Mom. Hi, Kim. So Mildred and I met yesterday in Denton, and we went to, it's not a scrapbook store. It's a, people donate scrap art supplies and they sell it. And they teach classes there. It's in Denton, just south of Texas Women's. I wasn't overly impressed with it. Paper-wise, it was okay. If you jewelry, knitting, stamps, that kind of stuff, it was good. But if you wanted like paint, it was a waste of your time. But this is what I got. I got a speedball brayer for just $3. And I thought that was a pretty good price because it's about half of what it would be. And then I got two sets of cardstock, the mat stacks, and they were $2 each. And I just liked the paper, you know. And then this was the other one. It's kind of vintage colors, which I like. Just some good subtle colors that are, and I like that a lot of the same tone but different patterns so that they would work well together. I like the little pads when I make some of my girls because the smaller prints make better clothes. So I got those. Then I got this sticker set, which is hard to see. It's just, it's that, and it was $1.50. It was just that plastic stuff that's bubbled out. And then I got these chipboard stickers, and they were $1.25. And it looks like somebody used, like, one word off of here, probably one little thing, and then donated it. So I thought that was cute. And then I got a calendar, and they had the calendars for 25 cents. And what I wanted, I've wanted a Castle one because I wanted to do some of the fashion girls standing in front of the castles. I thought that would kind of be neat. And I know there's kind of a glare on the images from the castles. Yeah, I liked the chipboard words. So we had a really good time. We met, we had lunch, and we went to the scrapbook store, and then that was about it. It was fun to meet. Okay, you lost me there, CB. So, okay, before I start this, Laura and I talked on her stream the other night, and they wanted to do, some of them wanted to do a napkin swap. So here's what I thought we would do is, anybody who wanted to join would either get, depends how many people want it, I mean, how many people want to be in the group. I've done it before where we did like 20, and I've done it before we did two types and it was 40. But you would just basically go and buy one package of napkins that had 20 to 25 in the package, or two if we want to do two. And you would take the napkins, they would all be the same, what you would send, and you would strip it down to a single layer, which helps on the shipping. So, and the way that I strip them down the fast way is I just take two pieces of Scotch tape and I just gently put it on both sides and pull. There's one, and most of them are three ply. This one's gonna stick and make a liar out of me. Sometimes the layer right behind the napkin can be tough. This one is. Usually they're not though. But you can, if you can get it started, but all we would mail is 20 of these or 40, whatever you want it to do. If you mailed 40, you'd get 40. These you just keep at home. I jelly print on mine. You can stamp on them and use them in mixed media, but you would either get one print or two prints that you would send. If you wanted to do 20, you'd get 20 back. If you did 40, you'd get 40 back. If you do 40, just do two prints, buy two packages. So you would send your 20 or your 40 in an envelope to me with a self-addressed envelope. So when you go to the post office, don't seal your envelope. Let them tell you how much the postage is for your 20 napkins or your 40 napkins, and then get the same amount of postage to send it back from my house to you. And so you would put your postage on the outside envelope, and then you would put your postage on the self-addressed envelope and stick it in with your napkins. So that way, when I get the napkins, then I would sort them all out, and everybody would get back 20 different napkins or 40 different napkins. And the one thing I would advise you is I've been in napkin swaps before. You want, patterns that people, butterflies, this is kind of what you want to send. This is not what you want to send. You don't want to send birthday ones. You want to send the decorative ones. But then anybody who wanted to join would get, like I said, 40 different napkins. For those of you who don't have a lot of napkins or don't have a lot of collage stuff, this is a good way to get a variety without going and buying 20 different, 30 different packages of napkins. So that's how it worked. Everybody would mail it to me with a self-addressed and postage on it envelope. I'll sort them. And then I'll mail them back in your envelope that you sent me. But you have to have the postage. If you don't put the postage on the self-addressed envelope, then I won't be sending any back. But that way you're paying. And when we did it the time before, I think we did 40, and my postage was like maybe $3 each way, and I was sending it to California. But that way, even somebody who's overseas, if they wanted to do it, they would be paying the same postage. So here's my email address, and I'll put it down in the chat too. Okay? The typewriter one came from Paula. I haven't used it yet, but I love it. All right, so here's my email. Oh, I have links on. Why did it do that? All right. Here's the first part. The smaller the envelope, the less it will charge you. When I sent mine, it also the thin, if you can put them in two stacks in here, that would be better, or you could even make them fit in here. I mean, and that's why I said take off the bottom layers because the postage will be less. And if everybody takes off the back layers. Oh, okay, CB. But that's what it is. It's daepps10 at gmail.com. So if anybody, let's say, anybody who's interested, if we say you email me by April the 1st, then I'll know how many people are going to participate. And I'll send out an email and we'll pick a deadline like at the end of April. Like everybody mails them to me by the end of April. And then I'll turn around and mail them back out. It won't take long to sort them and mail them out because they'll already have postage. So I'll just have to. Yeah, if you did 40, you'd definitely would probably want this size. And you could tell me at the time when you sign up if you want to do 20 or 40. I mean, and like I said, 20 is fine with me. That's probably what I'll end up doing. It just gives you a little variety. And I'll host it. That, like I said, that just helps the people that don't have a lot of collage. I use napkins a lot. Ange uses napkins a lot. But I know like Laura doesn't have any, hardly, just the ones I sent her. But that's a way to get a lot if you're new into art journaling. Okay, so the cat, let me pull this up. The cat is under here. This is the cutout, and I just taped it around to protect it. So what I did the other day is I took some of the watercolors to kind of look at colors. You would just send one of each. I don't use PayPal, Dorothy. You would put your postage on your envelope because whatever it is to my house, it should be the same cost back. If that makes sense. So, don't want to show anybody's address. If I was going to do it, what I would do is I would take an envelope like this and you would address it to me. Then you would take a second envelope. And you would put all your napkins in your second envelope, and this would be addressed to you. You would leave this open and you would go to the post office and have them estimate the weight, sending it to me. Then tell them before you put this in and seal it, keep it in the weight, but before you put this in and seal it, tell them you need to get the same amount of postage put on this envelope. So you're actually going to get postage put on both envelopes. And we didn't have any problems. It's napkins, Vicki, if you want. But I don't, I mean, that should work in the overseas too, shouldn't it? Yeah, so that way I don't have to deal with any postage. I'll just sort the napkins, put everybody's back in. Yeah, I mean, like I said, when I took it to my mail place, I just had them do this. And then I bought the postage for the self-addressed envelope and paid for it because I knew the weight of the napkins was going to be the same. Because I'm mailing 20 and you're going to get 20 back. Oh, they can't for international. Okay, so then we'll have to think of that. I don't do PayPal. Every time I try to do PayPal, things get messed up. So I don't use PayPal. Yeah, we could figure some other way. Oh, Jen did a stream that a while ago and recorded it. Okay. So for those of you who just joined, we were talking about a napkin swap. I'm going to go over it one more time for those of you who just came in. You would get 20 or 40 napkins that are the same. You would take off the back two layers so that you are only shipping the top layer. You would address an envelope to me to put your napkins in, and you would address a self-addressed with postage. Yeah, money order would work button. Make sure that you had your postage in your self-address, and you would get them, and then you would send all of that to me. I'll sort the napkins and send them back to you. Could be, Eileen, could be. So, and I did put my email on there. It's daeps10@gmail.com. I bet it was on Facebook. Oh, she told me she didn't think so. Okay, so here's what I did the other day. I put watercolors on the gray cardstock because I wanted to see what colors I would like. But then I got to thinking, I wasn't sure how the colors were going to work with the napkin. Yes, Lisa and Linda, email me for the information and I'll email everybody out. And I'll put dates and everything. And we'll try to keep it as simple as possible. Yeah, Laura, but you just take two pieces of tape. It's not that big a deal. Get Adam to do it while you're watching TV. So what I did was I took the same jelly printed napkin and I glued it down on the same cardstock, just a piece of scrap. This side here is all watercolors. I wanted to see how the colors worked with this taupe color. And I thought they were kind of dull. So what I did was I took some dazzling metallics and some fluid acrylics, and I tried the fluid acrylics. I know that on the bottom part, I've decided I want to use the zinc and the black pearl, which sound real dark, but they won't. And the background is turquoise. You have to remember that the background is turquoise. So I'm thinking I liked this lime green. So I might use a little bit of this, which is metallic, Fiesta green, and green gold, and do a thin layer on this top part in the green. Because I like the green with the silvery color. I mean, I really like the blues a lot, but it's got a blue background. So it was either the magenta and the silvery gray or the lime green. And I decided to go with the lime green just to make it different. So I'm going to get rid of the watercolors because we're not going to use those. And I have a piece of transparency next to me. I also have some Martha Stewart's citrine gold. So I'm going to put a combination of these on a transparency to use as a palette right now. And I'm just going to take a brush and I'm just going to start with a real thin layer of the green. And then I'm going to come back with the metallics. And then I think what I'll do when I'm done is cover it with the gel, the Mod Podge, and I'll use my pit markers. I'll use the India ink instead of, or I'll use the colored pencils as another thought. Yeah, I'm recording. And I probably won't be on, I mean, I don't know that we'll finish this tonight. I just wanted the napkin to still show up. And this is jelly printed napkin back. Yeah, I thought the green was pretty. And I wanted it to still be translucent enough, like a watercolor, so I thought the fluid acrylics would work. And this is green gold, and it's from the DecoArts mixed media line. Okay, I'm gonna put that up. And I'm just gonna grab a little bit of the metallics and brush on some metallic just to make it. And I am adding a little water to my brush because I just want to wash. I still want to see the napkin, so I may even I'm not worried about over here because that'll be under the mat in the end. All right. And this is Dazzling Metallic Fiesta Green. I'm going to lighten that just a little bit and then come back with a little bit of the other metallic, which is Citron Gold. I just want it to shimmer. Okay, so let me clean my brush out of that. Oh, I have my cat PJs on. It's almost always cat PJs. Okay, so like I said, that was the Festive Green, and then a little bit of Martha Stewart's Citron. Jen is in Las Vegas. And Sherry is there also. Well, she lives there, but I think she got a room at the same hotel that Jen was staying. Hi, Fancy. Okay, so let me make sure I get all that green out of my brush. And this is just taped down with painter's tape. Okay. Wipe that off. And now I'm going to use zinc and black pearl. And these are dazzling metallics too. And I think I'm going to put a little bit of silver sage in there to lighten it. I'll start out light. So these are all dazzling metallics. So I have zinc, black pearl, and silver sage. They're all by. It was fun yesterday, Mildred. I was so excited we got to meet. We still don't know anything about Jen yet and her specific plans. And like I said, I'm just trying to protect the background. I'm not going to worry about where the eye is because I'll go over with an opaque white and black. And I'm starting out with the silver, so it may not show up on your screen right now. Because the paper itself, and I'm brushing away from the sides so I don't get it under. And then I'll take this cover off. Okay, I need a little bit more of the silver sage. I know, I thought of that too. After we left, we didn't take a picture, but I have to say, I don't really take pictures that often. I hate myself in pictures. We should have done it when we were in the restaurant. I'm excited the fact that Shells might be moving into our area, because as big as our group is, it's surprising to me that until Mildred moved here, I was the only one in this area that I know of in the DFW area. Okay, so I may not hit all of this. I'm just going to try to dry brush some areas with the darker. And I kind of like this. I'm using the brush. Shells is moving to the Dallas-Fort Worth area. I think in the Irving area, Mildred, is what she told me. Her husband has, I don't think it's a new job. I think it's a promotion. Okay. Okay, now I'm gonna grab some of the. Some of the darker color, and just I want to, like I said, I want to do some areas. It's going to be kind of a tri-colored cat. I think it's in the spring or summer. I don't remember when exactly. It wasn't a sure thing. And then she kind of talked like it was, that she was starting to look at houses and or apart. Actually, she was looking at apartments to rent initially, but I told her that she probably would want to consider a house. Because apartment rents are super high right here, right now. Like, you pay more per square foot for an apartment than you do a house. Okay, I'm just trying to make it kind of modeled. I think I'm even going to come in with an oyster pearl, which is even lighter. This brush I left sitting in the water. See how it's bent? I love it. It's one of my favorite brushes. And I'm leaving some of the brush texture in there. Which again, you can't probably see on the camera. I'm going to come back with some darker. Okay, let's put that up. This might actually come together pretty fast. Faster than I thought. Yeah, I'm recording, Carol. I'll put it on YouTube as soon as we're done. All right, so let's take, like I said, this is just duct tape or painter's tape, I mean. I just wanted to protect the background. So much for protecting the background. I'm just trying to gently pull this off so it doesn't tear this paper. Yeah, it's tore right here a little bit on one side. me pull from the back. Well, it tore it off a little bit up here, but again, you're not really going to be able to tell once it gets in a mat. And I think I'll have to do what I did to the other piece. I think I'll probably have to mount it on something dark. I know exactly what I think I'm going to mount it on. Let me show you. Or not mount, but square up. No, that's too short. So this one should work. This is a 12 by 12 piece of paper. But what I'll do is I'll cut it down so I can get this to be a perfect like 9 by 12 so that it'll be easy to frame. So they'll just be a little bit. I'll show me. Pull out the arm and we'll cut this 9. It's already 12. And then what I can do is I'll glue that down. So if I need to, I have a square piece. In fact, I think I'm going to go ahead and go with it and tear this down the side. And that'll break that print apart so that when it gets in the mat, I'll show you. Because it will be matted. When it's matted, it will look kind of like that. I'll go ahead and add it to this paper. It'll also help with the weight. And I'm just going to use an Elmer's glue stick. To start with. Get it good and sticky. And then, like I said, I'll match this side up. And I'm going to take clean paper towel and rub it down. I'm not going to rub where the silver is right now yet because it might not be totally dry. It's actually not too bad. So let's throw all this away. And get rid of the glue. And I'm going to get our reference photo. And I'm actually going to tape him back together since I'm, it'll be easier to look at if he's in one piece. Okay. That way we kind of have a guideline to use. All right, now if we're going to use the pit pens, then I need to coat it in the Mod Podge. So let's put a quick layer down. Actually, before I do that, I need to put the opaque white real quick in here. I might as well. Where the eye's gonna go. And I'm just trying to put this where I can paint over it or use the markers over it. Okay. Hi to anybody who came in that I missed. Jean, Grammy, and Monique. Put that up. All right, I'm gonna avoid that area right there and let that dry. And like I said, I'll just put some gel medium and I'm gonna put it everywhere. I'll come back and hit this eye area in a minute. Edge of that. And then, like I said, we can use the pit markers. All right, I'm going to hit the eye area with some gel too. Got a baby wipe, make sure I didn't just kind of clean up where I might have smeared some of that white. All right, let's use the heat gun and dry this. So I'm going to turn the heat gun on. Well, congratulations, Aussie.
Okay.
Making sure there's no sticky parts. I go back to work Monday. I'm done pretending I'm retired for at least 10 more weeks. Then I can pretend again. Or I'll be unemployed. Okay. So I'm going to pull out green to use. And I think a gold color, a couple golden browns. And then grays, definitely. And then we'll need blacks, but let's, and I actually think I'm going to need, I think I want to put this in, right in where the nose is. It's more of a gray, but I think I want to put a pink undertone in there. And I think I'm going to put you know how sometimes on the white you can see down into their skin. It'll let me zoom the camera in since we're on the face now. Yeah, I should have played more this week, but there was lots of phone calls about the house and that kind of stuff. All right, so I'm going to take the gray and come in here on top of that pink. And give some definition to that area. And just keep, and if long as this is on the gel medium and it doesn't dry, I have time to move it. Now, once it dries, it's permanent. And this is a cold gray. That I'm using. And I'm just taking it off the background if I'm hitting the background too much. And I'm going to feather it in. To darken it. And then come back. Okay. I'm just working on the profile. And I'm just trying to darken some of that and make those transitions. And then just soften it. If I don't like it, I can just hit it with a baby wipe if it's too dark. Because I actually have a lighter gray. This is a 233, and this is a 232. It's still a cold gray. I think I'm gonna hit this with a little bit lighter. Shadow. And a lot of the whiskers will come in. And hit parts of this. Well, I like this lighter gray where it's lighter. Because this is not all it's kind of set in the way this is in the eye. Okay, and then I'm going to go back to the darker along here where the napkin is. I'm going to bring some of that farther down. And I'm just kind of using a circular motion. Okay. And when you switch colors, you want to wipe your fingers off. Yeah, I think it's a pretty combination. And I may even use some of the grays in the green, but I like the bottom of it so far. And You can see it's metallic, so it's got sparkle. Not as much sparkle up here, but we can fix that in the end if we think it's too dull. There's some, but there's not as much as there is down here. Okay, so now this is a darker color right here where the ear. I will tell you that the napkin went off this edge right here. So I think I'm going to deal with that and make it a shadow. And kind of shadow this side of the cat. And kind of shadow it. And I'm probably going to come in with the grays, also the darker gray. And darken up some of that green. Because it'll darken the shadow of that. And then this will. Come down. And I'm just going to pull, and then I'll come back in with my final line. See that a little bit better. I'm going to pull some lines in gray. I'm not going to worry about this on the white because it's not going to be white. But I'm just trying to get some of the movement, like directional. I'm going to turn it. I am going to throw some green in here too. Some of the gray with that green. Okay, then I'm gonna clean up on this edge right here. Where I've got a little bit of green. I don't mind if the gray's off the background so much, but I don't want the greens. Okay. And there's some fur on the ear that is right here that I think I'm gonna, I'll come back to this and work on it some more. I want it to dry a little bit. So I'm gonna pull some of that and give an illusion of some of that. And then I'm gonna do the same thing with the gray. You can't really tell. I'm gonna look on my phone real quick. Can't really tell if where the line is on this ear. Oh, of a Batman mask. Yeah, I could see that. But yeah, the empty, okay, so. Yeah, see, I can see the ear better on this photo where that line is. Now I can come in. I'm going to come in with some fine lines for hair. Right now I'm just trying to give a little bit of a. Shading. Okay. And I'm going to come in here. Some gray. Come down here and try to pull up some more. Oh, that was not what I intended to do, but I'm gonna leave it. I actually kind of like it. I think I will add some. Oh, that's a fine line. Like I am going to add some of that green in a few places where the silver is, and there's a shadow because it'll bring the green. Brings the green down. Okay. Like I said, I like some of that green in the silver. I don't know if you can see it. It's hard to see on the screen. Hi, Jess. Okay. Okay. That's more shadow in there. Because then the fur is gonna be, the hair is gonna be on top of it. Here too. It's reminding me more of a drawing that's tinted than painted. I think I want to put some of this green in here. Yeah, that made a difference. I don't think I'm going to give it green eyes. In the photo, it's got green eyes, but it's also a marmalade color. I think I'm going to give it a golden brown, which will pick up the brown here. And the other thing I may do is I may come back with the stencil and try to lay it on top and hit it again with the rich espresso after I'm done with the pens before I do the ink work. Yeah, kind of an amber eye, Jean. Okay. I actually think I'm pretty good with the way he looks right now. Or she. The time I get done with the eyelashes, it'll end up being a she. And I think I'm going to take some of this pink out. But just leave very little. Okay. Right, I think I'm ready to hit it with the stencil. I just had that was a crapalanch. Have the stencil right here. Okay, so I'm just going to try to figure out where I can match it up. Okay, I think this may be too hard. Okay. If I go this way. That's a match. That's a match basically right there on this side. I'm going to just do it, hit it. I may have to move the stencil in a couple places. So this is just rich espresso. Okay. I just want to add some of that back on top. Okay, I know that hits that area. Okay. And I think if I find, I need a, that's what I need. I've got this area matched up. Thought I did. Well, I know that matches, so I'm just gonna hit this here and there. If it's not gonna matter if it's a perfect match. Because the other is kind of lost. I need just a little bit of this flower right here. That just brought some of that napkin back and the copper to the surface. Okay, so let me dump that. All right, I'm going to turn the heat gun on this real quick. So, heat gun. And I'm gonna keep this heat gun on here close enough and hot enough to kind of blister that paint. Okay, so it's going to be real hard to see on the camera, but what it does is it gives it a bliss, a hammered effect. It gives it a texture. So I am going to give it, a quick coating. I like what I have so far, so I'm going to seal it and put a layer of the gel medium over it, and that'll trap it. Though it's permanent, it just will keep it. It'll also keep the black markers when I go to do the whiskers are gonna glide better. All right, so. Let me dry that real quick with the heat gun. Bye, Grammy. This has to be dry again. Thanks, Beth. It cannot be sticky at all when I go in with the pit markers. I am going to fix this little T up here. Oh, so this is a 1.5, and I'm going to start up here on the ear. And put in some hair. I am going to come in with a finer black. Okay, and then I'm going to get our photo back. And I'm going to go to a fine. put some of those hairs in. All right, I think I'm going to put in the eye color. I'm going to start with like a yellow okra, Naples okra is what I'm going to start with, just to get a base in. I'm going to kind of let that dry, and I want to darken part of it. Not all of it, just part of it I'm going to give. Let that dry there. And this is raw umber. And I'm going to come in and add a layer. I'm going to let it kind of be a little heavier again. In some areas. And I'm just using my fingers to kind of get those layers built. Okay. I'm gonna let that dry. Let's see if you can see it a little better. I want that to dry, and then I'm gonna come back in. I just want that layer to blend a little more and dry. Okay. And I'm going to come back in with the 1.5, and I'm going to darken this shadow area around the eye. And then I want to take the white paint pen and hit this edge. But then I kind of dulled it with my fingers because my fingers are dirty. So that just kind of, I'm going to bring, wrong black. And I'm going to bring this and I'll soften that just a little bit back. Okay. And then let's take the white. All right. I'm gonna get some. Then I'm gonna start down here. Okay, I'm gonna come back in and hit some of these areas. I gotta make sure it's not too wet. But I'm gonna hit some of these areas with the gray. You can't see all the whiskers. Okay. Then there's like a stray whisker here or there. I'm going to go ahead and put in. Just putting in a few. Dark whiskers, too. Don't know, it might be too much. I think it's okay. I'm gonna lighten some of it and pull some of it back. Maybe I need a new baby wipe. That one's kind of dry. don't know if I like the dark ones, so. It made it more cat. Okay, let's put some more. I want more brown in the eye. I actually think I'm gonna go with a darker. This is a dark sepia. That's getting more though. Trying to get a mottled kind of look, but keep some of that gold in there. I like that. Now let's add the black in. I'm going to use the black paint pen. It's kind of like a slit. Okay, I'm gonna let that dry. I'm actually gonna blot it a little bit just so it's and then I'm gonna come back in. And put a little reflection in. It's kind of got the reflection at the top. And when I come back in, I'm going to get rid of some of this white here in a minute. Okay, so I'm going to clean this up over here where I got white, where I don't want it. And I'm going to type that light color, put it over the white. I just need to round it more at the bottom. think that's pretty good. Yeah, she might be hunting a mouse. She's staring pretty intently. Darken some of that pink out of there. I put some of that sepia. This marker's needs to be cleaned. I think I'm gonna keep her. I don't think I'm gonna do the exaggerated eyelashes. I think I'm done with her, short of signing it. Let me put up these markers. Where they belong. Get them out of my way. Let's get the mat back. Think I'm gonna sign it right here in white. Okay, that needs to dry. Let me get that mat off there. All right, let's move this. All right, heat gun. I want to make sure that's dry. And I'm going to take a real quick picture of it before I mat it. So I can use it for the Etsy store. All right. Make sure my hands are clean. Yeah, the face really rounded, started to round out. And to me, it looks like a drawing that's been tinted. So I think my hands are clean enough now. I'll put the mat on there. I want the title to show. Yeah, I'll print it this week. Is crooked, so let's see. Let's see what we get when we tape this across the top. I want to move it down just a little bit. I think. Let's see. The paper must be crooked. So I'm just put tape up there at the top. And it'll stick. And then once I get one side stuck, the scrapbook paper might be a little on the crooked side. And then I'm just using mounting tape for watercolor because it's archival. Put a piece across the bottom. Okay. Something's stuck on that. Let me back the camera out and you can see the full picture. think he turned out, he can be he or she. I think it turned out really pretty. It's way different than what I thought I was going to do. But he's super shiny metallic. I keep saying he. So he must be a he. So. Yeah, about $30. I'll put her for $25 on and then shipping. Which I know is probably too low, but it's, I just would rather sell it than have it sit around. It's not about having it sit around. Like I said the other day, let me stop the recording. Yeah.